Friends, welcome back. In the last episode, I shared with you some basic rules of photography in order to take an excellent fit pic. Refer to the video if you haven't seen it yet. Today, I'm talking about the four tricks that I think are fundamental to taking an excellent fit pic. And like most good advanced aesthetic episodes, there's a homework assignment. Stay tuned till the end. I think you're going to want to participate. A fit pic is not just a good picture. A fit pic is an expression of fashion in a certain way. I have found a trend, certain qualities that I think are the fit pic special sauce, TM. They are body to image ratio, definition of garment and overall image, narrative quality, and overall novelness. These are the secret factors in the fit pic equation. First, body to fit ratio. Whether you're scrolling Instagram, Pinterest, or whatever, the ratio of how much body is in the image will affect the overall quality of the fit pic. Too little and you're an ant. Too much and it's like just your body. Using advanced Brave New Wear technology, we can analyze this Chiron fit. And activating the scan, Tron, to determine that his body takes up around 59.33% of the image. We also ran the Scantron on Jacob Keller. His body, 64.4%. Not to throw too much shade, but look at this guy, this pic.
Abort.
There's no head, the lighting's harsh, you know. Running the scan.
Warning.
84.4%. I think it looks awkward and clumsy. I think it's missing that quality.
How do you know what's good for me?
That's my opinion!
Now, naturally, you probably aren't going to try to calculate the percentage that your body fills in a picture every time you do it, but look at some pictures you might have saved. Look at some fit pics you might have admired in the past. And pay attention to kind of like where their head is and where the end of the photograph is. Pay attention to where their feet are, basically how much of their body is in frame, and try to emulate that. Definition of garments and overall image. We like fit pics because of the fit. If you can't see the fit, I don't even want to see the pic. The detail, clearness, the visual legibility of the garment is important. Your post will never get a comment like, clean fit bro, if said image isn't clean as well. For example, clean, plain backgrounds are often employed in fit pics because they are low contrast and let the clothes do the talking. Even in this shot where it looks a little foggy and there isn't a lot of light, the plainness of the background allows us to see the clothes well. Here's a picture of Gizmo, and the pavement complements his shoes and pants, but his pants aren't getting lost in the sauce. You could still definitely see the shoes, the pants, the definition of the clothes, and his green jacket definitely stands out next to the white building. Often you'll see people take multiple fits in front of the same place. And I think this can work as long as it's a place that you definitely can have good light with, and it's plain enough where the outfit is the total focus. Look at this guy, he's green as heck. The shade is almost the exact shade as his pants and his top, but with good lighting and utilizing strategic clementine placement, none of his fit is lost in the matching background. It's just another example of how defined his clothes are. Here's a bad example. We got Travis Scott. He's backlit. The weird light from his car is in my eyes, and it's making his clothing not visible. Narrative quality. What does that mean? Am I supposed to tell a story? The story of my outfit? No, you idiot. The pic you take does tell some kind of story. It does relay some kind of information. And if that information is, I'm a sad person who takes pictures of myself alone, it's gonna fall flat. It doesn't have to be Grapes of Wrath, but it helps when you're thinking about kind of what the viewer will interpret is going on in this photograph. Example, look at these two basic influencer types. They're in the Roman Colosseum, maybe some Greco-Roman building. The narrative here isn't so complex. It's two guys hanging out together in fancy exotic Europe. It seems cool and it works because it seems like they're just chilling. The story doesn't always need an analysis like this. and you don't have to go out of your way to create a thesis statement, but the kind of story that we might internalize from your image will play a part in whether or not it succeeds. Here's another example. You've got Steve Jobs in a crowd. He's smiling at us, smirking. We're all having a good time. We can tell what's going on in this image. Some dude saw Steve Jobs in a crowd, took a picture while Steve Jobs was noticing. That's the narrative quality. Overall novelness. FitPics, much like real art, should try to show us something new. If it wants to be better than the last FitPic. Novelness can sometimes allow us to break the rules altogether. If you do something weird, new, fun. Example, look at this guy. He's pissing. He's not even facing us. It's fun and different, it's crude, it's got a real South Park humor, but it's still basically a FitPic, but because it's like weird, it's cool. I love to see that. While posing in front of a matching vintage car isn't groundbreaking, it still shows us a little more creativity, a little more thoughtfulness that makes the pic different than just standing. Like here, you can break the body to pic ratio if you're being a little different. I know Slavs have been squatting for eon, but this guy's not wearing Adidas. We can see his clothes, we can see his outfit, it's well lit, even though his bod is huge. It still works. Do a dress up like an Eddie Salmon, Bob Dylan. Pair your fit with a cute apartment. Black and white photography probably won't work all the time, but it works out right with a pseudo rock and roll fit. Look at this one. You see the fit twice, IRL and in the mirror. And it looks like his face is comically squished. I love that. Great fit, it's novel. Don't get too hung up on the word novel. It doesn't literally have to be entirely new. But trying to add a little something fresh into your FitPic can go a long way. Having a girl butt in a picture is really cool.
Classic rock.
Very novel. People love butts, especially hot ones. And after all, girlfriends exist either to take a couple FitPic or of course to take all of your FitPics. So be careful because you always have to find a balance between an IRL relationship and being noticed online for clothes. Knowledge is only the first step to taking the ultimate fit pic. Execution is key. It will take a lot of time, a lot of shots, a lot of posts to hone your craft. And these tools are certainly something I'm going to have in mind when I'm taking my next fit pic. Since you guys have been so patient, here is the homework assignment for today's episode of the Advanced Aesthetic Series. I challenge you to go out and take a new fit pic following these parameters and add the tags of different fit pic aggregators. Snapshots, Grailed Fits, NCL Gallery. In fact, I would love it if you guys would share some of the best ones down below. I want everyone to know where to go to. And I want to see that based on these tools, on this theory, whether or not we can get our fits featured in those Instagram accounts. Additionally, I think we need a home base for our fits and our pics, which is why I'm announcing open access to the Brave New Wear Discord. It was previously exclusive to patrons only, and I'll still like them and they still help me a lot more than you do, but I'll be workshopping new benefits for them to make sure that they still feel special. Probably something along the lines of like live streams, something like that. It all depends. A lot of stuff is in the air right now and I'm getting kind of busy, so I need to see what works best in terms of time. But I would love you guys to join the Patreon. I'm gonna set up a specific thread for this video for the subject of our Instagrams and our fit pics. I'd love you to share and discuss, and especially let me know if you guys start to get featured. Only once has a fit of mine been picked up and shared in these aggregates. It was early in the channel's career. Frankly, it might have been like the Sunoco sandals video. After filming my masterpiece on my GF Caroline's roof in Brooklyn, I then forced her to walk around Bushwick with me. My eyes always open for potential fit pick opportunities. Passing one of many janky bodegas, I saw it. A chair placed next to a big pile of trash I cried and cried until Caroline gave in and took my picture in front of said trash. The rest is history. Hi, Snobiety saw the picture, thought it was a brilliant commentary not only on bodegas, but the art of fit pics, and shared the image on High Snob Style. Immediately following, my inbox was inundated with modeling agencies vying for my attention. My life became a blur of sex, drugs, and hip-hop, the modern day rock and roll. Then I woke up. Dunkin' Donuts coffee spilled all over my Margiela sweater. Caroline explained, garbage fumes that made me pass out. And she wanted to see a couples therapist because I was asking her to take too many fit pics.